You know, baby, you probably don't. But I'm glad you tuned in, cause it's about to be dope. Stick around for the Baby Biscuit Town Show. Biscuit Town Show, Biscuit Town Show,
yeah, Biscuit Town Show, Biscuit Town Show. Hi there! Expecting Baby Biscuit? I'm Little Happy Howie, the awkward brown boy next door. I love house music and helping others, especially biscuits like you. Catch me outside, literally. I like to sit under trees and overthink things. Like, why don't more brown people own homes? Or how do you stand out in a world of nearly 8 billion people? Makes you think, don't it? Guess you could say I'm always just a little worried about any and everything. Can you relate? If so, don't get stuck in your ways. In your days, in your doubts. Keep your head up, biscuits. Anxious biscuits like me and you will one day walk right up to the sun, hand in hand. In the meantime, I truly hope you've enjoyed season 2 of the Baby Biscuit Town Show. Stay tuned for more from me, Little Happy Howie. Hey, biscuits. Tonight, we have a very special guest on the program. She's a multidisciplinary artist, healing heart, mind, and soul through her rich and colorful artwork. Please help me welcome Miss Daria Love.
Thank you for being on the program. I'm so excited to have you.
Like, how did you begin as an artist?
My artwork, so I can think back to where I was 10 years old. Nobody knows. But it was Microsoft Word on the computer, and I kind of started off on Paint. The software Paint, and I used to make backgrounds and stuff off of there. And then around the time where I was like 16, I kind of got into like making flyers for my auntie. She used to have a daycare.
Okay.
So I used to make flyers for that, or like for the jazz festival. And then I took one art class in high school. I loved it. Like, I love my art teacher. After that,
ghoulies, I hope you enjoy tonight's horrifying melodrama, Equinox, the devil. The flying devil, that animated thing, it looks so creepy and surreal.
Yes.
Of course, that's our sheriff. And you saw the gripping sheriff scene with the lips and the mouth movement, whatever. Looked like a horse. I'm still disturbed by that scene.
And I was terrified as a kid. Job. Like, just so being weird and nasty.
Yeah, it very, very strange, very weird, creepy movie. Even the dark shadowy thing at the end after the devil explodes, and the ominous ending, of course. You know, those pictures started becoming moral fables and started having sinister endings in films. But I'm sure you enjoyed that one. If you haven't seen it before, it's a perfect classic for Crimson Theater.
Yes.
And of course, all the haunts are going. We're in October season now. It's really time out to get out there and support those haunted houses, or once a year that the season comes, and
It's over before you know it, unfortunately.
I just wish that sometimes the haunt actors were a little more schooled in the classics. They usually are not. Or even movies in general. It's a whole different world out there. But yeah, they should get into some of the old films a little more, maybe. Mm-hmm. Maybe not. Maybe it doesn't matter.
But create more range other than just standing
with
a knife.
It's just once a year, you know. And the other thing, I have the people, I'll run into them. I'm coming here to do the show, coming over here to the castle. They're like, well, it's not Halloween yet in May. And I'm always like, well, you got to understand something that's very important to think about. Horror movies, horror conventions are year-round. Horror films are made year-round. Yes, they're released year-round, okay? The whole monster culture. Now, prior to film, in all the decorations for Halloween, there was no Dracula, Frankenstein, Freddy Krueger, obviously, any of that. Actually, it was all witches and devils and pumpkins and scarecrows. And if you Google 1900 die cuts Halloween, you'll see how it was done. Just really interesting stuff. And not just black cats, but tuxedo cats are portrayed.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. So it's a completely different thing. Then you had horror movies, the genre, come around. Also, an important thing I tell people is that horror movies and Halloween complement each other. but they're not the same thing.
Exactly.
So go out and have a fantastic Halloween season. I know I'm going to. And you have a horrifying season. We'll see you next time on Dr. Destruction's Crimson Theater.
Recommandation des organisateurs. Tout au moins des responsables de ces petits. Alors nous avons une 125 au départ et certainement des 60, des 80 cm3 et les plus petites, les 50 cm3. Cela départ est donné. Cinq concurrents. Déjà la petite 50 qui se démarque en prenant la tête. Il y avait 6 motos au départ. Nous quittons le numéro 1 pour passer, suivre le numéro 2. Numéro 15 est deuxième de la course pour le moment. À vue d'œil, c'est certainement une 80 cm3. Deuxième position. En troisième position.
Canal 10-3. E-App di Direct Media Curaçao HH. Download E-App Novo, tanto riba App Store e Play Store, buscando TVD 10-3. Assim é fácil. TVD 1-3. TVD 1-3. E desfrutar de um aplicação completamente novo. Fácil para tragone e com sem fim de possibilidade. Muito mais conteúdo. Notícia 10-3, Bopor Mire e a noite mês. Mira videoclip dan dinos artista nan local. Volve a disfrutar de bo show nan favorito, a word mais fácil. Goza de música na Radio Direct Chinchete e Direct Live 92. Mira que hora bo programa nan como gusta, tapasa e hopi mais. Disprime riba e link e download e app novo de Direct Media. Of search TVD 10-3 de Play Store of App Store. Direct Media. Creciendo e avance tecnológico. Vivando cubo cada momento. Dengue mundo aquí y tecnología moderno.
Seven hours and his blood is still alive.
Night of the Blood Beast brings you the first creature on Earth bullets cannot kill.
This is fantastic. It's unbelievable. Things like this just don't happen.
A blood beast that makes a dead man live.
Dr. Wild, half his head's gone.
A blood beast that feasts on Earth scientists. The first satellite creature to impregnate man with its chromosomes.
It's true. I can feel it inside.
The exploration into living space, exposing secrets too horrifying to reveal. You'll know days of nerve-training suspense. It's first-degree terror when you see Night of the Blood Beast.
Hi, I'm actress Courtney Enea from boarding school, and you're watching After Hours Cinema. Enjoy.
Hey, and welcome back to After Hours Cinema, our third break of tonight's feature. We're going to shift gears from 20,000 BC to the present to highlight a Deep South paranormal group based right here in Mississippi who are doing some deep dives and investigations on some of the region's biggest ghost legends, from the Robert Johnson at the Crossroads to Voodoo Queen Marie Laveau. Here's the trailer to the new series, Ghost Legends. Hope you enjoyed that sneak peek at Ghost Legends. Now let's get back to the finale.
Yeah, 1979 to 1980. Tell the people your name, please.
My name is Alexis Adler, and I've been with Jean-Michel Basquiat. It was such a privilege, and he was such an amazing person. And I'm so glad to be able to share this work.
You know, it is Diverse City. We're here. We're about to show you all the art. And thank you so much for your contribution. Because people can't see this unless you showed us, so I appreciate
you. This sweatshirt is a sweatshirt that John painted.
Wow.
And and he would paint these and sell them on the street.
Oh my God.
And this is not very good.
It is really cool.
Like, very cool.
You see it. We all want people in a diverse city to get back. Uh-huh. Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you. I want to thank you for being such a good steward of history and preserving and knowing that in 1979 and 1980, when you were in school trying to get out of undergrad and become the embryologist you are today, and you saw, according to you and Felice and other people, this sometimes knucklehead who was also a creative genius, and you saw something so early, earlier than, you know, Leo Castelli, earlier than Larry Ngozi, earlier than Mary Boone, earlier than all, Alexis said to herself, you know, this gentleman is going to be special, and I'm going to make sure I preserve this, and I'm going to capture it. And boy, does she have an eye. Maybe you should have gotten to the art deal.
Hey, yo, this is Kissy. All the way in New York from London. Check the t-shirt on. I can't help it, man. We're all one people in a diverse city. Uh-huh. Coming at you, boy.
Double, 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 double open. Let me swing. Just got the door open. Let me swing. Think I got the door open. Let me swing. We got the door open. Let it swing. We like the 18, nigga. We let it swing. We like the 18, nigga. Let it swing. Yo, yo. It's outrageous for y'all to talk to talents, my famous. If it wasn't for gangsters, y'all would remain nameless. Y'all scared money to me, y'all more Wes Craven. When you ain't pippin' them hoes, you a fresh hater. Let's face it, top five is never the favorite. New York's a matrix, it's hard for these cats to escape it. It's for the culture, that's why I'm over the shaping. I'm a different fabric, I can sew it and make it. Just call me the greatest, no need to debate. In Cali, swimming in pools, my Miami's getting faded. Still on the law, every day I'm still praying for my enemies before they do retaliation. What up? Let it swing, Fox got the door open. Let it swing, Fag got the door open. Let it swing, Chess got the door open. Let it swing, Finko got the door open. Let it swing, we got the door open. Let it swing, we like an 18 nigga. We let it swing, we like an 18 nigga. Let it swing, yo.
World is a ghetto, and in this world I'm king. Refuse to let these puppeteers hang it by a string. Feel like MJ back when he got to that sixth ring.
You know what it is. We were sitting there, and you and your infinite wisdom, but Dr. Lewis is very smart. If I was one-third as smart as he is, I'd be really smart. So the bottom line is, he's making a magnificent point, sitting right in that chair over there. You ought to put a camera on that. And I was sitting on his right. And the, what do we call this guy? You the director of the show?
Sure.
Yeah, see, hear that sheep in there? And Jay came out from behind a camera. This should get us kicked off. And the poor guy, it must have been some medication he was taking, because the poor guy had an eruption of gas that was like a rhinoceros would have been proud of.
Oh.
You know? And Dr. Lewis, I looked over. He was hiding behind the camera, him right there. Look at how proud he is of himself. Look at how he's proud.
That happens.
Anyway, Dave's face went completely blank, and you couldn't stop laughing. And I had to take on three times we went back to you, but if anybody doesn't think gas is funny, go ahead. Sorry.
I could not contain myself. I'm sorry.
But anyway, these are the things that I guess that's what makes us all human. Caller, do you have a question?
Ask a question. Yeah. Yes, I do. You know, so what you're saying is, if I suffer with headaches on a regular basis, my aspirin gland isn't working right.
See, you know, taking a question from an insider, you really know that the man knows what he's talking about. They also said in other ways, there's not enough aspirin in my system. That's why I have headaches. Mm-hmm. But as you all know, is that the question you were going to ask?
Well, I'll let you go and answer that question relative to headaches and the causes and effects and, you know, a variety of aspects to that. You guys are doing a great job tonight, really.
Thank you very much. And thanks, coming from you, that means more than you know. Deva, thank you. All right.
All right, we'll see you guys. Take care, buddy.
As Dr. Lewis said, okay, headaches, what do headaches have to do with chiropractic? Yeah. Our friends in the medical profession who did research study found, and you know exactly what I mean. Do you want to say it?
No, you can say it. Go ahead.
Go ahead. Dump in on me. You know, we're going to get to you yet. That neurologically, the...
Well, I think I'm going to take a little bathroom break. Oh, yeah. Me too. There's only one bathroom upstairs.
I don't want to know.
Sir, both radar beams are bouncing off our ship.
Well, it certainly took them long enough.
Hold on. Turn on the radar shield.
Monsters, thrills, and chills. Tune in for classics of sci-fi and horror on Theater of the Fantastic. Some of the best, and not so best, of classic sci-fi and horror run on Access Channel 99. Featuring stars like Bela Lugosi, Boris Karloff, Basil Rathbone, and many more. Check the schedule at MoreheadAccess.org and tune in to Access Channel 99 on Morehead Cable or on Digital Channel 68 in the entire Metro on Cable 1. Theater of the Fantastic on Access Channel 99.
Clean kitchen surfaces, utensils, and hands with soapy water. 1 in 6 Americans will get sick from food poisoning this year. Keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.com.
Did you buy the flashlight and the batteries?
Yes.
Okay, Steven, you really don't want to get sent away?
No. I don't want to go anywhere.
Okay. This is what we're going to do.
It don't happen when you get a when you start liking somebody that has that many followers. I was like, okay, so I got the inbox and they requested me as a friend. I accepted the friend request.
Of course he did.
I did. Of course I did. Now, 5 minutes later, I get an inbox. I'm like, wow. She inboxed me? But that was the first red flag. First red flag. I already knew what it was because I'm familiar with this type of activity.
She really likes me.
Petty.
I am the type of petty guy that when somebody inboxes me and I know that they are a catfish, I like to fuck with them. That's just what I do. So let me go over this conversation with you guys. She starts out by saying, and I'm not going to mention the name just for purpose. You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to mention the name because I'm not going to get paid for this shit. So I'm not about to advertise her shit. But let's just say her name is Kat. So Kat inboxes me. And Kat says, how are you doing? I said, I'm good. Thanks for asking. And yourself? She says, did you get my new content? I'm like, okay, so you ain't even going to answer my goddamn question? Sure, because you're a catfish. AI. I said, no, I didn't get your new content. She said, what are you doing right now? I said, chilling. She said, oh, I'm just on bed.
On bed.
I'm just on bed playing with some creamy ass right now.
She wanted to show you that her booty hole was brown.
Petty.
I said, what, do you have diarrhea? She says, yeah.
Petty.
She says, do you want to go nasty with me, baby? I said, how do I do that?
You was going to play with the diarrhea?
She says, I'm going to make a private video of me masturbating while mentioning your name.
Oh, wow.
She said, what is your name, though? I said, Steve.
Hi, Steve.
She said, guess you know I charge.
Oh, wow.
Now, this lady by the name of Kat. I've already followed her page, and in her page, she's already said, like, look, I got 200 and follow, I got 200 and something follow, 1,000 followers or whatnot. I do not get in people's inbox. I do not show my pussy. I do not do any of these things. So if you see anybody doing this, it's not me. And I'm totally aware of that. I send her the actual video of who she's trying to be. I send her the video. Like, bitch, this fake. This is crazy what happens next. Oh, after I send the video, she says, got 20 on app. Let's go ahead. I said, this is a fake page. You are not real. She said, nope, it's me. So I sent her the video again of the real lady. And then she says, next, can we still do a video call? You are not real.
Petty.
You lame-ass niggas make this shit possible day in and day out. They are so aggressive, and there's so many of y'all still responding and giving y'all information and paying for these videos in all hopes that this is the real person. It's out there, y'all. You have to watch catfishing, because now they're catfishing as far as you trying to find a house, trying to find a crib.
Yeah.
These people are saying, yeah, I got a crib for you. You can meet this person at the apartment or the house that you're trying to get, and they will ask for a deposit. And once you give the deposit, they will run off on you. Catfishing is real.
Petty.
Cash App is glitching.
The glitch Cash App thing, yeah.
If you send your Cash App information to these people, they will steal your money. They will get into your phone and rob your bank account.
So what is they asking for, like, your login and stuff?
They asking for any information. A matter of fact, like I said before, if you give a person your Cash App information, they can take that information and get into your phone.
Just even, like, if you just send them your Cash App?
If you send them your Cash App, they can get into your phone and get into your personal bank accounts.
Wow.
And rob you.
Petty.
It's evil.
That's them scammers. That's them scammers, bruh.
It's taking them so long.
Who cares? Let's start the movie. They'll just have to catch up.
Thank you. Yes, let's get going.
Anybody move, cut him down.
Cavalry comes in and saves the day.
Always.
Now, what did you think of the show, Tangella? I don't think she was watching. I think she's more interested in Sammy.
Yeah.
She's putting him back to sleep. He was awake for a moment, and then she came in and began petting him, and now he's a slumber again. So what's next for you after this run of the circus?
So after the circus in Sonoma, I'm going back to France.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Right.
Because I have a project there with my blues band in France.
Right.
And I need to write.
And the blues band is different than the gypsy
different
jazz.
Than the gypsy jazz. And it's a different musician, it's a different ambiance.
But you sing.
I sing.
Right, right.
Yeah, and I write the songs.
Right, right.
So on the blues.
How fun.
And so we have a project to do a new LP.
Nice.
You know?
Right.
And a tour.
Are you going to do actual vinyl?
Yeah, we love that.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, good. We love that. Good. CDs is fine, but you know, right. All the... You know, all the new
the
technology.
The analog fat sound, yes.
I love the vinyl.
Yeah, nice.
So, yeah, this is my project. And also working for the Festival d'Avignon to see how I can maybe organize the show and bring the American troupe in France in July.
That'd be fantastic.
So,
yeah. I'm sure our friend Ken Gaw would love to.
Oh, the magician Ken Gaw. Yeah. You know, it's the best magician on the world.
Right. Yeah. We have him on often for that reason.
Oh, yeah.
Good, good, good. Yeah. All right. Well, absolutely wonderful. Well, thank you so much for coming on the show.
Thank you.
Do appreciate it. We'll come see the circus with you soon.
Thank you, Vincent.
And next time you're in town, come see us.
Yeah, we are. You know, and thank you to welcome me and Sam here, and we are very honored to be in your beautiful house.
Isn't it nice?
Yeah, it's
not quite as nice as a circus tent, but it'll do.
It's nice, you know. Thank you, Vincent.
All right, thank you. And as far as you guys go, thank you so much for staying up late and watching the show with us. We know you could have been watching something else, but instead you stayed here with us, and that makes you absolutely wonderful enough so that we love you. We'll see you next week, and have a wonderful rest of your weekend. So, Michelle, you know this whole thing with the circus. I've never been in a circus before. I've been in a band and I've done all this other stuff. Do you think you might be able to find me some position?
Yeah, you have already the clown costume, my friend.
charges for? Huh? For being ugly? For having a cow horse hybrid? No? You killed your family of four last night.
I knew I forgot to turn off that campfire.
Barbarella, really?
Oh, Butch, you silly possum.
Hey there, you guys ready to order?
Yeah, I'll have the chicken piccata.
All right, and for you, sir?
I'll take the ravioli special.
Okay, that comes with a choice of appetizer. Would you like a super salad?
Yeah, I'll take that.
No, sir, I think you misheard me. I said soup or salad.
I heard you, and I want neither. I want a super salad.
The gentleman at table 40, he wants the super salad.
Bull, he must have misheard you.
He asked for it specifically. I'll just tell him.
No, you're not gonna tell him anything. The only thing you're gonna do is bring it to him.
But chef, last time you made a super salad nearly killed you.
Everyone line up. I made an oath. We all made an oath when we started working here. Now, what is that oath?
Customer is always right.
What is that oath?
The customer is always right.
You're goddamn right. Now, let's make a goddamn super salad. Move!
What the f*** is a super salad?
I've heard a lot of great things about this place. I've been dying to come here.
You've never been to Olive Garden before?
Heavenly Father, we ask that you look after our brother and devotee to your safer ways.
May you grant him safe passage through the dark valley that lies before him.
And through your grace, may he find the kingdom of heaven, where super salads are served eternal. Amen.
With the Lord's strength and the divine powers of ketchup, mustard, and ranch, I declare you, Chef Gary, worthy of making a super salad. Now rise. Gary, do you wish to call the children first?
There's no time. Bring me the scriptures.
You have any siblings?
I have a brother.
Oh, cool. What's he like?
Don't know. He's been in jail my whole life.
All right, sir, and here is your super salad. I was just informed by the chef that we're actually out of chicken piccato. Is there anything else I can get you?
I'll just get the rigatoni.
All right, I'll put that in for you right away.
It's about time. The f*** is this?
Is it okay if I touch you?
Yeah.
Oh, good.
And then I took my hand off after a few seconds.
And so I'm starting to fall in love with her. Like, I know I'm stoned, but like I can see her in this whole new way. Like, you know, I always thought of her kind of like a kook. But now I'm seeing like all these other sides, like, and she's like super smart and she's funny and she's touching and she's like complicated, you know? And I'm like, her face is like morphing like 24 times a second. And I'm just seeing all these parts of her and my mind is like blown away. And I'm like, wow, can't believe I found you. And basically like, I'm in love.
But I don't want to kiss you goodnight.
Okay.
So then we kind of like hugged awkwardly, and then she kind of hurried back into the house. So I go home, and Mandy is like,
well, how was it?
It was great. I really like her.
Did you have sex?
No. She didn't want to because of you. She didn't want you to feel bad.
Oh, well, that speaks well of her.
I know. She's a really nice person.
So I can't stop thinking about Ashley. But she's about to leave for Georgia for a month to help her parents move out of their house, which had just been foreclosed on. And I really want to call her and see her again before she leaves, but I don't want to come off too desperate. And also, that night, there was a screening of the show about the show that I had to do a Q&A for, and that Mandy also wanted to go to. And then during the Q&A, someone asked what Mandy thought of the show. And so I asked her if she wanted to answer the question herself, and she did. So she came up and did the Q&A with me, and she actually got really, really into it, and she actually wouldn't stop talking. And afterwards, she said that she'd never been able to watch the show and really appreciate it before because she's in it, and, you know, it brings up feelings for her. But this time, she was able to, and she really, really liked it.
Kaveh, I love the show. I really want to keep doing it with you.
So I was like, ah, great. And we're kind of getting along, and we've been getting along better ever since she went over to Jamie's. And then she says,
hey, I'm having fun here and I don't want to leave yet. Do you think I could go home and relieve the babysitter?
Yeah, sure.
So I went home, relieved the babysitter.
Thanks.
And then Mandy gets home at like 2 in the morning. And I'm like,
where were you?
I ended up going to Jamie's.
Were you guys like being physical?
It's none of your business.
So I'm like, why would she say?
It's none of your business.
If she wasn't being physical, she would just say.
No, of course not.
But so I'm like thinking, this does not compute. And then a few days later, we get stoned together, and that's when she finally admits it.
Yes. I've been having sex with Jamie. I had sex with Jamie on the day I told you I wasn't gonna have sex with Jamie, and we went to the park. We didn't go to the park. I just had sex with Jamie, and it was great. He's great in bed. I'm really into him, and I'm in love.
Well, I'm glad you're in love. I'm glad you had a great time. I don't mind you having sex with Jamie, but I wish you'd fucking told me instead of lying to me. Because then I might have been able to have sex with Ashley. And by now, Ashley has already left. And I'm like, ah, you fucked over my night, my chances. You fucked them over. And so I text Ashley and say, and then Ashley wrote back, meaning like, you know, you're so upfront and honest and accepting. Like, why would she need to lie to you? She didn't need to lie to me. She could have just told me the truth, but she didn't want to because I think maybe she just didn't want to be in the show. But anyway, Mandy texts Jamie to tell him that I know now that they had sex. And Jamie writes back and says, oh, we gotta stop doing this. I feel terrible. Kaveh's gonna hate me. He's my friend and I've cheated on him. And Mandy starts freaking out.
Don't worry. If you want, I'll text him and tell him that it's totally okay with me.
You would?
Yeah, sure.
So, after my text to Jamie, Mandy and I started getting along in a whole new way. She was in love with Jamie, and I was happy for her. And she seemed happy for me, too. You know, I would talk to...
Give it up again one more time for my man's Ray Jackson. All right, again, we're going to keep this show rolling. We know how we doing it, so we already got the thing going. So I want y'all right now to give it up. Give it... Man, when I say right now... Give it up! Jay Montgomery!
Thank y'all so much. Happy Halloween Day in Ohio. Oh, shit, y'all saw the curse and thought I ain't have a deep voice? Shit, I know it's Happy Halloween, but this shit is in my scalp. God damn, this is not a wig. This is me. I know I got a Bone Thugs and Harmony t-shirt, but damn, this is me. I'm gonna miss everybody, all right? Some of y'all high as hell. That laugh was late than a motherfucker. Oh, shit, man. Yeah, thank y'all for coming back to the All-Star Halloween show. My name is Jay Montgomery. Is my mic on? It just sounds like that. Oh, this one of them, like, corded phones, you know, like growing up. When you got that call, you knew exactly where to go to in the house to know you as far away as you could be. We need a corded phone. At least a microphone that's free after 9 and on the weekends. But happy Halloween. I know some of y'all, it's just a happy day. I done looked at some of y'all, and I was like, oh, shit, is that real or not? I know y'all done looked at some people that smile and shit, you know, look like they eat cookies and don't drink milk. And I ain't talking about just Waffle House. I'm like, in general, this day, this is like the hoodest country's capital of fucking Ohio. And I'm from Birmingham. I knew y'all was country when I saw a Church's Chicken over here. I ain't seen one since Birmingham. Oh, it's boarded up? Not all. Some of them may be getting more than some chicken right now, but we're going to go to the next topic of the conversation in this bitch. Man, y'all ever realize, you know, people with no neck only know how to move that motherfucker when they got some good food? Let them pull up to a Popeyes and everything fully stocked. Oh, the microphone coming back. Hey, this is Jay Montgomery. Hey, thank y'all for having me. But no, let you see somebody with no neck have some good food. It'll be like a Luther Vandross song just came on. Never too much, never too much. Oh, man, you know, I was going to dress up as Halloween. For Halloween, I was going to do Lord Farquaad from Shrek. Yeah, y'all see that shit. Y'all ain't shit. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Y'all tried to be nice and not laugh. No, it's a goddamn comedy show. But shit, you know, throughout the year, they always tell me what I look like and not what I am. You know, in the springtime, I look Hispanic and shit. I was in Miami in the springtime, and the Hispanics thought I was Hispanic. Shit, the niggas thought I was Hispanic. I'm just trying to get gas. They trying to tell me that shit in Spanish. I don't know what they saying. Now, in the summertime, I do get a little dark. So, you know, I have had a few Muslims ask me if I want my own gas station, you know. I done almost took them up on the offer. In the fall time, I'm indigenous. People who passed that graduation exam laughing. Everybody else cheated. What the fuck that mean? In other words, fuck them colonizers. Shit, I'm from the South. I'm mixed. I'm hella mixed. My mama, she black from Detroit. My blonde hair, blue eyed. Let's go, Brandon. Make America great again, daddy. Yeah, he from a county in Alabama. You know you're from the country when they tell you a county and shit. I got five white sisters and three black sisters. I done heard my five country ass sisters call each other hoes. Good boot.
Forrest Gump.
Oh, God. 2 hours of my life I'll never get back. I'd rather spend it watching the Home Chopping Network. Were you expecting someone?
I wasn't.
Hold the remote. Mr. and Mrs. Talbot! Oh, nice to see you this evening. What can I do for you guys?
Well, Mr. Johnson, I was just wondering if you could help us out. I'm trying to find my son. Where he might know where he ran off to.
He must have climbed out the window. I was in the kitchen all night, and I didn't hear
him. So you
see him?
Webigail, could you come in here a minute? Webigail, have we seen Stephen this evening?
No.
Webigail. Webigail.
Stephen!
Oh, Stephen.
Thank you for your time. Mr. Johnson, we won't be bothering you anymore this evening.
It has been no trouble at all. Don't think of it at all.
Listen, Webby, I have to go. But before I do, I want you to have something.
Oh, Stephen! It's beautiful.
Let's go, Francis.
No! Don't forget about me, Webby!
Right to you, Stephen! Send me a ghost card!
Fluffy, eh?
It was Heather's idea. Well, I'd say it's about time we go, eh, dear? Come on!
Yeah. You know, it's like I always say, better dead than dead.
Come on, Lou!